If you ever mention to anyone that you want to start baking, you'll get 100 suggestions as to what can be your first bake. But even before you try your first ever bake, is there anything that might be helpful to know? Definitely there is. This is Suma Rauji and you're watching Cakes and More, your channel for beginners in baking. If you like this video, please do share and subscribe to my channel. You can watch this video in Hindi on my Hindi channel, link in the box below. So if you have decided to start baking, let's begin with an introduction to baking. It's very important and extremely necessary. You can find all the links to related videos in the box below the video. First and most important, baking is a science. If we want cakes soft and our biscuits crisp, we need to follow certain methods and rules here. You'll need to pay attention to small things such as baking temperature, baking tin size, baking tools, mixing methods, baking ingredients, and such things. In case we do not do that, we cannot expect good results. Weighing ingredients. This is extremely important. You might be surprised to know that the best of bakers and pastry chefs across the world weigh ingredients for baking. In cooking, you can generally taste and adjust the salt, spices, sugar, etc. as you go. But you can't really do that in baking. A little bit of salt and sugar here and there may still be alright. If you use less of baking powder or baking soda, your cake may not be fluffy enough. And if you add too much, your cake will smell and taste funny. More of cocoa powder will make your cake bitter, and less of it will not give you the taste of chocolate. So absolutely no guesswork here, please. Always weigh your ingredients for best results, even if you are extremely good at cooking. You can get a simple digital weighing machine. You can get it at a nearby departmental store or even online. I have given the link in the box below. Standard measuring cups and spoons. Cups and spoons in baking always refer to the standard measuring cups and spoons, and definitely not the ones we use at home every day. Here, 1 tablespoon is 15 ml, 1 teaspoon is 5 ml, 1 cup is 240 ml, and half a cup is 120 ml, and so on. Different ingredients have different weights. You can use a baking chart for easy reference. I have one on my blog, you can refer that. For measuring liquids such as milk, oil, and water, you'll need to use a liquid measuring cup. These cups are generally used for measuring dry ingredients. I will soon be making a detailed video about measuring ingredients correctly. Please do watch that. Baking tins and pans. You'll need to use tins and pans which are made for the purpose of baking. We cannot use household steel utensils even though they might look and feel similar. In the beginning, always use the same size as recommended in the recipe for the best results. You can experiment with different shapes and sizes later. I like using aluminum tins best, but you can also use silicone and oven safe glass. You can use these both in an OTG and a convection microwave. I've made videos about baking tins and pans, you can watch them. Ingredients. Using the right ingredients and using them correctly are both equally important. Using the wrong ingredients can ruin your cakes and biscuits. The best ingredients are of no help if you do not use them correctly. For example, you can't use baking soda in place of baking powder and baking powder in place of baking soda. Similarly, you can't use cocoa powder in place of chocolate and chocolate in place of cocoa powder. I've made a few videos about baking ingredients in detail, please do watch them. Baking tools. Using the right tools can make your work easy and also make your end product a lot better. Using the right tools can make a difference between a good soft cake and a rock hard one. You'll need to invest in a small set of baking tools such as whisks, spatulas, cooling racks and such. You can watch more about these in detail in my videos about baking tools. Techniques. Following the method given in the recipe and every step in the recipe is very important for best results. Melting chocolate properly, separating eggs correctly, proofing yeast the right way, grinding almonds and other nuts so that they're not oily. Basic techniques can be very helpful and help make your cakes and your cookies better. Oven. Of course, you'll need an oven for baking. You can use either a convection microwave or an OTG. I've made videos about how to choose an oven, how to use ovens, such as convection microwave and the OTG. I've also made a video comparing the two of them side by side. You may find these videos helpful. So after listening to all this, where do you start? Get to know your oven, gather some information about basic baking ingredients, baking tools and tins. Put together your basic baking kit and then try out really simple recipes. Follow recipe instructions always. Every ingredient and step in the recipe has a role to play. So do not make any changes or skip a step. There is an entire playlist of very simple recipes on the channel. No matter how many videos you watch or how many classes you attend, the only way and the best way to learn is practice. try out really simple and easy recipes from reliable sources. That recipe from that manual or behind that box may not really work. If you try really simple recipes from reliable sources, you will definitely succeed and you'll want to bake again. That interest, enthusiasm, and that continuous practice is more helpful than you think. Don't try converting recipes into endless ones. Make notes as you bake, that will really help you. And then the concern that baking is unhealthy. Well, if you do not bake at home, in all probabilities, you'll buy something from the store. And trust me, anything you make at home is a lot more healthier than anything you can buy. The stuff you bake at home has no chemicals, no preservatives. They're really fresh and you can make them to suit your taste and preference. And then there is low-fat baking, healthy baking, whole grain baking, baking with millets and whatnot. But then again, to do all this, you'll have to learn the basics. I hope you found this video helpful. Please do subscribe to my channel to watch my new videos. And do not forget to check the description box below the video. You can find the links to all the videos I have mentioned in this video.